Hey guys, welcome to a restoration video. Since I do a lot of work on my other one, I was basically looking for one as a spare, because most of the time all I listen to is albums, and I ran into this for $19. I figured, what the hell? It probably had a cartridge on it. Someone stole it at a thrift store, which is no surprise. You'd be surprised. They steal badges, they steal anything that can pop off of a device, they'll steal it. I'm surprised they didn't steal the weight off of this. It's not that bad, actually. I don't know the year of it. I went to boot up my computer, and apparently my hard drive died. So, I haven't had a chance to actually look it up, what year it came out. Right off the bat, I can see that the rubber feet on the dust cover totally rotted off. A little bit of damage. Not major. Just really needs a good cleaning. So what I was about to do now is wipe it down, just to see if it how bad the scratches are on it, and then we'll see what's actually wrong with it, if anything. I was gonna scrap it for parts. One thing I do need for my other turntable is wire, but I think I'm just gonna leave it together. It's getting harder and harder to find old turntables, and I'd feel pretty bad if I scrapped it. I paid $300 for a turntable, and the thing was a cheap, total piece of junk. It was nothing like these old ones. Even the motor assembly and everything in it was all the old cap, or not the old, but the cap stand that you would use in a tape deck. Really cheaply made. Wow, that is not bad. I've seen worse dust covers. That's actually pretty decent. The dust was protecting it, maybe. Someone has not used this in a long time, but it's pretty good. Has a legitimate weight on the back. Yep, sweet. Anti-skate, which actually works. The bearings feel good on it. No playing it or anything else. But the cueing. Okay, there's one problem. The cueing does not go down when you bring it down. Okay, so that's probably why I was sitting in some dude's closet, because, oh no, maybe it is working. Once you put weight on it, it should be fine. It is working, it's just very slow. Cool. Let's see what half decent mat. Still gonna need a cork mat if I want to use it. Wow, considering its age, it's not even warped. It's not a very thick platter. It's very thin. This is the type of platter you get with some of the cheaper stuff nowadays. But it's there. No belt. It looks like what belt was on here has disintegrated. There's nothing left but crap. Black crap all over it. There's a place where you can oil it too. They're telling you where to oil it. Okay, let's turn this thing over. Let's move this. Scratch it up. We're going to turn this thing over and take the screws out the bottom and see what it looks like. That should be alright. Yeah, I figured it would be nice to have a spare, because when I work on my other one, it's usually offline for a couple of days, if not longer, and lately I've been rushing it just so I can get it back on running so I can listen to my albums. This way, now I can take my time on it and use this one. Screws later. That's excessive. It's not even a heavy unit. It's all dusty on the inside there. Wow. Okay, this is really different. For one, this isn't a cheap little capstan motor. It's really nice, actually. Probably needs to be oiled. It has auto return, which is a surprise. I'm guessing underneath here would be the wiring for the arm. Not much to look at. The oil is still soft, which is a surprise considering its age. Yeah, everything is pretty much still oiled. Yeah, there's not much here I can really service. Like, there's no electronics or anything. It's not a bad thing. Everything is still oiled. I'm not going to bother re-oiling everything. It's still soft. It's not dried and crusty. And this thing here can be oiled from the other side. So I'm just going to wipe the lid down, get the dust out of it, and throw it back together. And we're... get a cartridge and make sure the queuing works. And I don't think we're going to have to really do much else to it. I think it's good to go. Take it upstairs and try it out. Just give me a minute to put this back together. One thing we need to do is we need to find something to scrape the crud off that spindle. And then maybe try and oil it. It doesn't feel like it needs to be oiled, but due to its age, I'd say it probably needs to be done. I don't think alcohol is going to take this crap off. It's baked on there pretty good. Slightly rub it off. It's working. Try it out. We're gonna need a belt. It cleaned up pretty good. It's nice and shiny. Cool. I do have an extra belt. There we go. drop it through that little plastic thing of doodad. Not sure what that is, unless for the speed. Changes this belt. And it does exactly what it's supposed to do. Sort of. Well, let's plug this in and see if it'll even spin. Should have done that right away. A little bit of noise in the motor. Can you hear that? I'm sure you're going to hear that through the turntable. Oh, that sounds terrible. Maybe having a little motorized capstan wasn't such a bad idea. After all, just like one of those ones just going to sound really bad. Let's be clean too. Let me go get a cartridge and see if we can't get this balanced properly. See if it actually functions as it should. An old record that we can play with. Can't say it was much of a repair video. Everything seems to be working. This is my sacrificial. Look at the scratches on this album. It's basically for testing. But everything is working like it should. The cueing works. Turns on when you bring it out. It doesn't drop the needle. It comes on nice and slow. You can really hear that motor though. I want to try oiling it. See if it shuts it up. Like I said, if I can hear the motor through the platter, even after oiling it, then it's no use to me. What I'll do is I'll basically pull the arm off and a few other parts and use it to build a new turntable, basically. I had planned this summer of getting really, really thick wood and just basically carving out a turntable out of it. But I needed an arm, and obviously I need a platter and everything else. But it does sound a little bit quieter. Let's see if the cut works. Or the return. Well, that's a surprise. Look at that. Wow. Cool. So yeah, I'm going to try oiling the motor and see if it makes it any quieter. Well, I oiled it. It does not sound any quieter. Can you hear that? If I put the phone up against the turntable. Yeah, so it should be interesting when I hook it up to the amplifier to see how it picks it up through the turntable, which I'm pretty sure it's going to be loud. It might not be. Maybe the belt will isolate it, but it sure sounds pretty loud. If that's the case, then the tone arm's coming off and the rest is going to the trash. But we'll see. Take it upstairs and try it out. It works well considering its age. It does have a few issues that I need to work out. One, I'm not too sure if it's a bad RCA coming out of the turntable. It might have been yanked, but one channel is out. And I've already pretty much taken the cartridge off and turned it up a bit so there was a hum and touched the pins on the inside of the socket. And still one side only. So I don't know if it's the wire in the arm itself or if it's where it's soldered on the board. Or someone's yanked one of the cables and ripped it on the inside. But I flipped them over. And it definitely is one channel is out. But other than that, it works great. The speed is constant. It's nice and smooth. Tracks well. Doesn't anti-skate. Doesn't skate or anything like that. The return works great. The only issue is with that motor. Hear how loud that is. Now, I'm going to try actually taking the whole motor out and repacking it from top to bottom. It says to oil it from the top, but I'm pretty sure it probably needs oil on the bottom too. And that should get rid of that noise. It doesn't come up even when you put the stylus on the end of the record here and turn it up with the headphones. I can't hear that rumble through the turntable. So I thought it would transfer through the belt or through the cabinet itself, but it doesn't. But that was still driving me nuts, that noise. So I let it run for a couple of hours after I repaired it yesterday. And I oiled the top, but I know for a fact that the bottom is going to need it. But other than that, it's fine. It sounds really good. So I'm probably going to keep it together. I'll see what I find when I pull the motor apart. See if I can shut it up a bit. If I can shut it up, I'll include it in one of my vlogs that it's working a little bit better. There it goes.